Hubie, here is the scene.
All alone at the cat's cabana, me waiting for Hubie, waiting for Hubie. 10 years, 10 years, 10 wonderful, marvelous, beautiful years. Waiting. I know he isn't working late at the office, because he hasn't got an office. I know he isn't being kept overtime at the store, because he hasn't got a store. I know he's out somewhere making a big deal. Big deal. I know what he'll say when he walks in here. Baby, how are you?
Baby, how are you?
Beautiful, and you?
What are you sitting here?
Where they put me.
Who put?
They put.
Captain.
Oh, don't start that. Will you? Every time we go out, it's the same thing. Lousy table, big beef, and nothing happens.
Let me handle it, baby.
What would you like?
A better table, got it?
See you, Captain.
See well, you, dirty. Here, Captain.
Don't I get an excuse? Not even a lie?
Would you like me to bring a note for my mother?
So where were you?
I ran into this big deal.
Did it hurt much?
Come on, do you remember Wolfie Farber?
Nope.
He's mixed up in the coin machine business.
Who isn't?
But guess what?
What?
He offered me 200 jukeboxes.
Oh, he must be a real friend.
Yeah. All I need is 20 G's for the down payment.
Well, I can start you off with 12 bucks.
Thanks, baby. Thanks for the ice water.
Say, he wouldn't want to trade those jukeboxes for the 3,300 hula hoops you still got laying on my father's garage, would he?
Hey, keep it up. I'm going to be sorry I even came late.
You came late, so you wouldn't have to dance with me.
Now, why would you get an idea like that? Where?
Well, why? Because in the last 10 years... Happy anniversary, by the way.
Oh, right.
You've danced with me twice. The night we got married, New Year's Eve 56, when you got stoned and thought it was VE Day.
Me?
You thought I was Ida, whoever she is.
Look, you see me dancing with anybody else, then complain.
I don't want to wait. I want to complain now.
And a happy anniversary to you. Boy, you're a bundle of fun tonight. I'm here, Captain.
See you in a minute, pal.
Here's the routine. Little lady and I celebrating our anniversary. Now, she don't
see. Listen, Mac, we're doing the best we can. This is opening night.
What are you screaming, buddy? What are you yelling?
You give him a little authority to go berserk.
Look at him. Take away his uniform. What is he?
Naked.
Yeah. You don't need a wise guy like
him,
buddy.
They're all like that. You know,
come in these joints, you get here, honey. Who's that table for?
That's for a biggie.
Yeah? And that one over there?
VIP.
What is that, a bigger biggie?
Figures.
What is she, VIP-er?
Yeah, I love it.
Sure, we're stuck here in Siberia. What do I need? What is this, wagon train? What is it?
Looks like it could be John Henry Wheeler.
Yeah? What does he do?
He's just the number one man in the entire jukebox and record game, that's all.
You're kidding.
Uh-huh.
Him?
He's got the right angle and the right business.
He looks like such a...
Just the way you got the wrong angle and the wrong business.
Boy, you're starting early tonight.
Not early, and I'm not a boy.
And let's watch the show, huh?
And their third golden record this year, the one and only, the Why You Came, the Glad You're Here, the Swinger!
Is going to be the greatest, because ladies and gentlemen, guess who's here? Mr. Music himself, our boss, John Henry Wheeler!
Don't start.
Did they carry you all the way home?
Don't worry, pal. I'm going to collect plenty from them.
You should. You gave them one beautiful floor show.
Please. Turn off the Victrola.
Thanks for dancing with me, by the way.
Again with the dancing. What are you, some kind of a shill for Arthur Murray?
So where were you till now?
I was walking the streets. I was worried. That was no joke what happened. I think I strained something.
In your back?
No, my head. I'm getting sick and tired of being pushed around like some jerk, while characters like John Henry Wheeler get the front table. Listen, what's the big deal with him? He's got three names. I got three names. I just don't use Malcolm.
You better take two yellow ones tonight.
If I could just lay my hands on a lousy 20 G's, I'd show you, I'd show everybody. 200 jukeboxes. You know what Wolfie Farber says?
What?
A man can make a nice living with just 8 jukeboxes.
So why don't you buy 8?
I ain't looking to make a living. I'd rather be dead than make a living.
Boy, the way you tear yourself up. I see people all around, not on top. They make up nice lives. They're very happy.
Oh, yeah? Let me tell you about those people. They're really miserable. But they're so stupid, they think they're happy.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. Why should a jerk like John Henry Wheeler get a front table? And you and me stuck in the middle of some chariot race?
Who cares?
I care. Where you sit is everything in life.
Not to everybody, Hubie. Like my father says.
Oh, please, don't give me your father, huh? Your father, 61 years old, sweating out every buck.
He's got a nice cleaning and pressing business, and he enjoys it.
Good luck to him. I'm on a different pitch, and I don't need him or his advice.
You want to start on the top? Jump off the Woolworth building. Oh.
Father, the great philosopher.
Yeah, but always looking for the lucky number. Where's it got us?
Oh, boy, you just like to bust my bubble. Why is that?
Because you're my husband and you're too old for bubbles.
Yeah, old is right.
I wouldn't say that. In the last 10 years, you haven't grown even one day older. Not to me.
Happy anniversary, baby.
Come on to bed,
sweetheart. Oh, if I could just think of an angle. You know what I mean? A break. the right place, the right time.
Can't you calm down?
Does Howard Johnson's wife keep telling him to calm down?
But why aren't you special tonight?
When I see a punk like Wheeler, there's just one thing I see. If he, why not me?
Heaven's sake, with my papa in his business, please, Hubie, in his super cleaning pressing business, you could make your way, be the boss someday. Listen, Hubie, all a woman wants is that her man should have a job.
A job? Please turn off the vitroler.
Stores in Brooklyn and in Queens, it's a very healthy business. Please, Hubie. Opportunity's been knocking, but it's 10 years by the clock. How long can it knock? Listen, Hubie, all a woman wants is that her man is not a slob.
A slob? Please turn off the Victrola. A woman should egg a man on to bigger things, better things. You wouldn't like me, Kay, if I was punching time every day. I'd lose my personality and my dash. I should be a biggie with a load of cash. 'Cause I'm a dreamer, a schemer.
Take a job, for heaven's sake. My papa in his business. Please, Hubie. Dreamer, schemer, schmemer, look around you, find out what's the score. We're not kids no more. Listen, Hubie. Be secure, be safe, be sure, and settle for a job.
All I need is an angle, an angle, an angle, and some timing, timing. All I need is an angle, an angle, an angle. It's the angles and the timing that count.
Take a job, for heaven's sakes. Take a job, please, Hubie.
I couldn't even get a table for my woman. Take a job, for heaven's sakes. Why should I take a job like a slob? I got style, I got class. And all I need is an angle, yes. All I need is an angle. One thing I can't get through my brain.
Take a job, take a job.
Why not me?
Don't be a dreamer, a schemer. Take a job, for heaven's sake.
All I need is an angle.
Take a job, for heaven's sake.
All I need is an angle.
Yeah. I want to thank you very much for the peace and quiet. Yes. I'll dress in the hall. Want to do me a favor? Call your father. Tell him I said the cleaning and pressing business. For him, not for me. Yeah. Why don't you want to phone and give him a ricky dicky? Say, hey, daddy. Hey!
Excuse me.
For what?
My stack for blowing it.
Happy anniversary.
I can't help it, but I guess it just comes from because I'm so left out of everything. I don't know. Maybe I wasn't meant for this type of world altogether. Maybe this world should just belong to those John Henry Wheelers and their jukeboxes.
Close off, sweetie, not on.
Yeah, boy, in my day we used to have real slot machines in New York. You remember? Had personality to it. Clanko, jackpot.
Congratulations.
Yeah, and real men running things, not squirts.
Oh, some men, hoods.
Fatso O'Rea, king of the slots. Oh, what an organizer. Skin Demopolis, a little Greek chic, always in a dough. Did I ever tell you about him?
Only about 4,000 or 5,000 times. And Brains Berman, the power.
Yes, you're the power. Wow. When the three of them together formed up a combination, took over everything, and I was right in there with them.
With them? Under them?
Come on, those were the days.
Sure, you were grim and got kicked around. All they did was send you for coffee. Where'd it get you or them?
Yeah, well, there's something wrong with a world that's got John Henry Wheeler on top, and Fatso O'Rear has got to run a... I think they call it like an ice cream parlor in Union City, New Jersey.
That's a good place for it.
Yeah. If I had the combination with me today, wow, I'd go to Wolfie Farr, but I'd pick up those 200 jukeboxes. And I would...
Okay, so now you're dressed, so now get undressed.
If I had the combination with me today... If I had the combination with me today...
What's the matter, honey? Your needle stuck?
If I had the combination with me today... Okay.
What's the matter? You got the Hello Joes?
Honey, you know I'm always looking for the angle. This could be it.
Oh, here we go.
Go. Yes, gotta go.
Well, now, where?
I gotta go find Fatso O'Rear in Union City, New Jersey. Honey, this idea is so great, I'm scared. Look, baby, I know how I've been. I'm gonna ask you one more time. Believe in me?
Sure, baby, sure.
Sure, baby, okay. Oh! What idiot leaves cigarettes where you can make a... Honey, you gotta do me a favor.
Yes, sweetie, what is it?
See what you can find out about Skindamopolis. Will you, dear? Ask around town. You know what I mean, like where?
Listen, are you sure you want to get yourself mixed up with characters like these characters again?
Rains Berman. Him I think I know where. Skin, I'm not sure. See what you can do, will you, baby?
All right, I'll
find out. Oh. you knew I forgot. And you're standing there making a laugh out of me. And you know all the time that
what's the matter with you tonight?
Waiting, waiting, 10 years out of 10. QB's a bargain.
And I have got the most terrible hunch that Phil's going to get in an awful lot of trouble in the next scene. Because Phil gets an idea. He rounds up some old buddies, racketeers, to start a jukebox racket. That is legitimate.
I want to open you up.
Huh?
Fatso, don't you remember me?
Hubie?
Yeah, Chief.
Beat it!
What's the matter?
Don't bother me.
Bother you? You'll be glad I bothered you. You'll jump.
What'd you do, bust out of some funny farm someplace?
Yeah? Hey, does pretty good, this slot machine, huh?
That's no slot, that's a juke.
Yeah, what's the difference? Did you hear that one? I say it again. What is the difference? You want an answer? No difference.
I don't get you.
All right. What's your cut out of this box?
No cut. They put it in, they changed the records, and it cost me nothing for music in the joint, which you gotta nowadays.
Yeah? How would it be if I came in here and asked you to put in a different kind of box and cut you in a little?
Why, you in that business?
No, Fatso. We are. I got a load of the guy. They tell me he's the head man of this operation. Fatso, one look at him would turn you to nauseous.
You would?
Yeah. And looking at you, I'm getting nauseous.
Watch yourself!
A guy like you selling goo.
I can't get a liquor license.
That's so. To take over this whole operation, all it needs is 3 points. 1, organization. 2, little power. 3, little dough. All right. When it comes to organization, who was the greatest?
Ain't I looking right at him?
All right. Now, who's your number two and three?
Number two would be Brains Berman.
A very good number two, only you forgot one little detail.
Which?
He's dead.
Since when?
Since he died.
Ah, you got him mixed. Brains is running a chicken farm in a little town. I think the name of it is Upstate New York. Yeah.
Well, in a case he's not cooled, he's a good number two.
And for number three, Skindamopoulos?
He'd make a... What am I saying? No!
But Fatso...
Don't promote me! Beat it!
But Fatso... You know, you've gotten thicker in the middle with the years. And don't tell me you also got thick between the years. Fatso? Ain't you gonna put the slug on me? Fatso, say it ain't so. Say you're still my hero of long ago. King of ice.
Aha!
With that look that can turn me to a block of ice.
What?
That's it, Fatso. That's the way you used to be.
Start talking!
All right.
This is the greatest angle of all time. The slots guy's coming back. There's more money in these jukes than there ever was in a slot.
Keep talking.
People keep putting money in. Why do they get back?
Noise.
Keep talking.
Now look, a record costs a buck. It brings in over $200. Is that a long shot to order the one?
Keep talking.
Down, listen to me. Listen to Variety. Last year, the jukebox industry over $300 million.
Keep talking.
And it's out the open. No protection to pay out. No back rooms. They could even have it with a chocolate ice cream soda.
Keep talking.
It's legitimate, it's as pure as the driven snow. Nothing sinister, fit for a minister. Respectability, hello, hello. It's legitimate, honesty will fill our cup. It's on the up and up. Yankee Doodle went to town because he was no phony. Legitimate was he. Legitimate are we.
What do you say, Fatso?
It's legitimate.
I told you. It's legitimate.
It's pure
like the driven snow.
Nothing sinister.
Fit for a minister.
Respectability.
Hello.
Hello.
It's legitimate.
It's legitimate.
Honesty will fill our cup.
It's on the up and up.
Sure, I love the dear silver they poured in the slot.
So legitimate, legitimate are we.
Legitimate, you see, legitimate are we. Hey! respectability.
Hooray! Hooray!
It's legitimate. It's legitimate. Never was your show the last to win the Nobel Prize. Yankee Doodle went to town because he was a bone. It's legitimate. Are we?
Corporate taxes. Here we go. Capital gains. Hello, hello.
It's legitimate. It's legitimate.
A great pro.
Thank you. God, all I remember you. Is 10 weeks ago you said, just come over and take a bow. You pleasure, Ed, and thank you for speaking so well.
What I want to tell the audience, this is just a slice of this. It's one of the greatest musical comedies ever played on Broadway. This fellow is one of the greatest all-time stars we've ever had in our theater. Because at the St. James Theater, it's going to be very difficult for you to get tickets. But when you write to him, tell him that you're a personal friend of Hubie, and that'll straighten it out. The St. James Theater, New York. Let's have a wonderful hand for Phil, Nancy, and all the Phil. Well, come on, let's hear it there. Let's hear it there. You know, so much goes into the making of a star like a Phil.